Hey folks, how you doing? Dirty back with ya for Let's Play of the Deadly Tower of Monsters. So we made it up to kind of this little section of the tower. Let's check out our upgrade section. I don't think we can do that much because we got no gold cogs. Isn't that how it always goes? Okay, so we're at the Temple's Altar. What's over here? Yeah. You know what? I'm not a big fan of the shib thing. Let's go for a space baton. And let's go for a pointy stick. We'll go with the classics. And let's head into the next section of the Deadly Tower of Monsters. Okay, yeah, we ran into those two monkeys last time. Are we actually back a little bit?
Funny story about the two caged apes in this scene.
I thought we heard this already.
I had completely forgotten about them when we wrapped up filming.
Because we're going to have, like...
set. Then we spent the next day doing a location shoot. So, suffice it to say... our return to the studio was met with a couple of grumbling tummies complaining about unsafe work conditions, human rights,
heard that part before.
Yada, yada, yada.
Maybe the game put us back a little bit?
Hey, Patrick, I was thinking we should take a little break.
Yeah, we heard this part. Well,
you like Chinese?
I guess I'll just kind of power along so we get to the section where we... Actually, I'll check our...
Hey, you have to try the shrimp.
Check
the
thing
absolute
here.
Best.
Let's check out our
map. Oh, hey, I feel like I should warn you. It gives me horrible gas.
I think we were up here last time.
That's okay, we're friends.
I guess maybe I quit the game a little bit too early last time before we actually hit the checkpoint, and that's why we're back a little bit. So,
studio time costs a
fortune. Sorry about that.
Good thinking. We can grab our real dinner together.
If it takes me too long to get to the next point, what I'll do is I'll actually start
the
recording here. You guys won't know the difference. I'll be like, hey, look, we're back at this section where we left off. And you're going to be like, seems right to me.
All right,
so this is a big old
blorgy
thing.
Made the budget back for that matter, but... hey, in the end, I think it was still worth making, just for those...
wow, that's a lot faster to kill if
really
you use a melee
it.
Attack.
I attended a lot of sci-fi and movie cons, and to this day,
sci-fi
I still see
movie
fans
cons.
Showing up dressed as aliens and apes and dinosaurs. Does a man proud. Now, granted, their costumes aren't exactly 100% faithful to the film... and it seems that no one ever remembers them by the right name. But still, knowing that we still have fans like this promoting the film decades later, it puts a tear in this old director's eye. I get all emotional.
So let's see if there's anything down that way. Doesn't look like it. All right.
Okay.
Again, hopefully we're not that far from where we left off last time. I don't think we are.
Tony and his insistence on lens flare. I tell you, some days it felt like he...
I guess we'll get to do some more Shatner lore. If there's anything that we'll gain from this, it's the fact that we get to do more Shatner roll. So, I am a pro Shatner roll person.
Like my fingers aren't clean enough to wipe the lens.
Was it up here we ended up?
Whatever.
Let's check it. Yes, I think it was actually up here. So, okay. So we weren't that far behind. I don't think we can do any upgrades. Again, I don't have any idea how this leveling system works. And the game never provides an explanation. So we'll just leave it at that. We'll pick up a cog here. Again, there's an upgrade station, but we don't have any gold cogs. So that's pointless. And I'm happy with our equipped weapons. I think we got up to here last time. I didn't actually hit this checkpoint thing. That's what happened. Okay. So we weren't that far behind. We are now at a giant fan. Hello, giant fan.
Danger. Human speed is not enough to pass through that fan. Chance of death 100%. Retrieve the time vortex device if you wish to go any further. Searching. Time vortex device detected. Device in dangerous area. Nuclear amps everywhere.
Okay, so we're gonna go back down now to scroll down. Okay, there we go. The nuclear ants are over here. So we will jump back in earlier that we've been to a little bit earlier in the game. and we will search for the Time Vortex. So if you remember from, I think it was the first episode, we saw this bridge and it was like, hey, there's nuclear ants here. And we did see these inflatable rocks. Oh, we can now take care of them.
In the first place? Did he do any research before landing there? Did he have a specific mission in that region of space?
Patrick, if you keep getting bogged down by the details, how will you ever learn to just sit back and appreciate the work of art for what it is? Production tip, ladies and gentlemen. No matter how sunny it is, don't store your papier-mâché props outdoors. They will get rained on. It's the law in this town, like Occam's razor or Stockholm syndrome or... I forget what it's called.
What in the cosmos? It's my co-pilot's body! I believe that I can repair him.
I believe I can fly.
Oh no!
Oh no!
I am trapped!
Oh, that's some excellent dialogue. And they got the puppet there again. I love the dick puppet. So limp and loose.
Master Dick.
No comment on that.
Beep. Functions restored.
Alright, so we are now the robot.
Must eliminate.
Fun fact! Hey, we actually had an actor inside the robot suit moving him around. I bet you thought it was an actual robot, huh?
I did. I believed with all my heart that robot was an actual robot.
Hardest working actor I've ever met. What a trooper. It was a shame we couldn't afford to pay him. And of course, since he wasn't on the payroll, I couldn't officially add him to the credits.
Hopefully we don't get knocked into the water.
What a trooper. Wish I had a dozen actors like him.
I don't think I've showed you yet what happens when you fall into the water. There's a giant sea monster that eats you. And the game just kind of resets from your last checkpoint, I think. Thunk, 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 thunk. So this is, we're nearing now the furthest that I got in the game, so we're going to reach some points and some director dialogue that I haven't heard before. So, yeah, things are going to get interesting from that point, and you'll see me kind of fumbling around a little bit more as I try to figure out what to do and where to go. So just keep that in mind. Like, up to this point, I've played this section of the game before, so I've had a preview of where I had to go and everything, but everything pretty close to past this point will be new to me, so I'll let you know when that point is, and then you don't have to wonder why I seem so confused playing through more of this. Unfortunately, these little ants that I'm facing now, they're almost the same color as the terrain. It's hard to see them sometimes, and it's hard to know where to direct your flamethrower. Doing a circle of death here. The old Mech Warrior 2 tactic. Okay, thunk, 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 thunk. Alright, so we'll continue onward and upwards. Do robots care about radiation? I think they could.
No, we didn't use the same material for the toxic waste as we did the slimes. I mean, why fake something when you have the real deal available? We found a place where people were just dumping the stuff away for free. I was hoping the crew members handling it might get some cool superpowers from it, but no, nothing like that.
Alien slimes terminated.
Good job, robot. Can we Shatner roll with the robot? Yes, we can. Okay. That's the most important thing. As long as we can Shatner roll. Let's not walk through the deadly slime. It's off against the pill bugs here. Cog over there. More pill bugs. Okay. Let's see. So we have an upgrade station here. Again, I don't think we have any gold cogs, so Yeah, that's pointless for now. What do I have here? What's this? Okay, yeah, I do want to change it, the tuning fork, for a poking stick. A little bit more range. Seriously, there's still more of these things? Alright, I'm going to go up the tower, and I should actually, before I do that, as neat as the flamethrower is, I prefer... Where's our Tesla gun? Okay, I think we already have it selected. E. Okay. There we go. Kill it with electricity. Thunk. Okay, bring us up. It's a floppy dick. I guess what we know, we know what the next name of this episode is going to be. Aliens coming from below!
I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger.
Oh, that's an awesome delivery. Actually, hit the thing? Hitting the thing might be good. Pyro Shepherd. I guess that's for getting kills by leading the enemies into the fire. Don't fall off. Oh, okay, there's a thing that actually brings you back up if you fall off here. Cool, that's what those things are. I'm trying to figure out what they were. We're running very, very low on health. Stay ahead of the fire! Stay ahead of the fire! General! Oh, we got the... Oh, we died.
Hey, now what's going on? This isn't the right cut.
Oh, we earned a skill point. So, there we go. So, yeah, they just say if he dies, like, oh, this isn't the right cut, so hopefully it'll bring us back to the start of the boss fight here. Sorry I failed you, YouTube. Really? We're all the way back here?
What in the cosmos?
Okay, let's... Can I skip this?
Co-pilot!
Oh, I can fast-forward it. Neat. Master Dick! Master Dick!
Threat detected. Must eliminate.
Alright.
Fun fact! Hey, we actually had an actor inside the robot suit moving him around. I bet you thought it was an actual robot, huh?
So you see that, the director's commentary doesn't change between playthroughs, so... It'd be great if it was a little bit more dynamic if they had different cuts and stuff for different playthroughs, but... That's it, c'est la beat.
Add him to the credit. But still, what a trooper. Wish I had a dozen actors like him.
Too many of these pill bug things. Got all kinds of pills, give you all kinds of thrills. But the thrill that... Oh, I missed this cog last time, I think. But what I need is gold cogs. Darn it, I was kind of hoping I could just run up the tower. But I can't. Actually, the flamethrower is a little bit better for these little gold ants. Because they do come in groups. Fairly easy to kill with the pointy stick, though. Come on, baby. Hunk of burning love. Seriously, you can calm down with the ants now, game. Come on. Come and get me. Okay. Maybe I'll just try to stick with the flamethrower. Since we didn't do too great with the Tesla gun.
Your dangerous radiation detected.
Okay, let's see if I can actually just bypass this. No. Darn it! Darn new game!
No, we didn't use the same material for the toxic waste as we did the slimes. I mean, why fake something when you have the real deal available? We found a place where people were just dumping the stuff away for free. I was hoping the crew members handling it might get some cool superpowers from it, but no, nothing like that.
That's a lot of combat to go through without a checkpoint, actually. Come on, robots. I believe in you, robots. Just hit it with your stick. That's the point that we're at right now. Just hit it with your stick. There's one. There we go. Okay, see if I can make a run for the tower now. There we go. Stay back, Bell Lance. So here we go for it with our boss fight. Shatner roll.
I will strike down upon you with great vengeance and furious anger.
Sounds like Dr. Spatzo. The Blade of Labs.
You know, a hero means business when they take a shot. There's from a
throwback.
A monster and shoot it
back
right
in the day, if you had a, if you,
in my professional
like,
opinion,
PCs at one point didn't come with sound cards.
Hey, Patrick,
believe it or not.
Throw something at me real quick.
What? I'm sorry, sir, but I don't think
so. If you wanted like cool things
to
increase your gaming experience back in the 90s, one of the things you would get is a sound card. Like especially with the old Origin games, like the old Chris Roberts games, the Wing Commanders and whatnot.
Oh, robot!
Okay, we
you're
killed
all
it this
right.
time.
And you saved the day.
You're eliminated it.
Why is
Looks
there a
like
pirate ship in the background?
At long last, we have assembled our team.
Go us!
A lot of reviewers and fans too.
So yeah, you'd actually buy like a sound
scenes
blaster
with
for
all
your
three
system
heroes
and it would,
in it together. I
you
mean,
would, you'd be able
to
do surround sound. I don't know if
it's
surround sound stuff, but
about the sleep chambers or
you'd have better music, basically, for
your
games. It would increase your,
really, it was
your
just logistics.
Audio fidelity
Jonathan
and stuff like that. I don't know. I don't really know how to explain it. Oh, we just got eaten by the sea monster.
Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Honestly, we almost never had all
okay, so
of
where
them
do we have
at the same
to go?
Time.
So we are now at the point where
some religion that only allowed him to work on Sundays.
Yeah, we're now at the point where I haven't played this section of the game before.
Sir,
so
just a guy in a suit. Couldn't you have gotten just about anyone
this is
to
all
stand
new to me.
In as the robot?
See, that's why you'd make a horrible director, Patrick. His touches were subtle.
There's another
the
cog here, okay.
But he really brought a lot
grab
of
that.
Character to the robot role.
If he was so indispensable, how come you didn't list the actor in the credits?
Well, let's just say it was an oversight. But I've learned my lesson. I only made the mistake 6 more times throughout my career.
Okay, what's over here? Toxic factory. So we're supposed to pick up this vortex thing. So the giant fan's up there. I don't think we've actually picked up the vortex thing yet. So again, this is new gameplay to me. So I gotta figure out what to do next. And I really messed up kind of my description of why you applied a sound card back there. But it's something you would do back in the 90s. You'd pick up a creative sound blaster. Anyway, the point I was trying to make about that was sound blaster would come with like some text-to-speech software. And one of those was Dr. Spatzo, which was basically a very early chatbot. It was supposed to be the kind of this virtual psychiatrist, right? So anyway, it was a chatbot with a digitized voice, and it would sound a lot by our he would sound a lot like our friend Robot here. So anyway, yeah, I remember when we got our sound card. It was a big deal back in the day, and also getting our first CD-ROM and having to install that was a bit of an ordeal. Actually, I think we spent because we got a CD-ROM drive for Christmas one year. Because, you know, your system wouldn't come with any CD-ROM drives, typically. So yeah, you'd have to manually open up your system and install it. And that was, I think we spent a good deal of one Christmas morning just trying to get the bloody thing to work. Okay, so I am a little bit lost now. Checkpoint Nuclear Ant Island. We have our team assembled. Toxic Factory. And we're not being directed where to go right now. There's some more ants here. What happens if we try to leave the island? It's just the monkey man. We can just stand here and relax, not doing anything. Okay. Cool. But where's this time vortex, yo? Do we have it? Okay. It's this Z thing or Z thing. Okay. Gotcha. Alright, so we should be able to go up to our giant fan. There we go. And so we put this thing down now, and this is going to slow down the fan. So I do have to wait for it to recharge. And it seems to take a long time to recharge. Let's change back to our Tesla gun. There we go. We've made it! We've made it through the giant fan. Alright, so yeah, again, this is all new territory to me, and you might expect me to die sometimes, because holy crap, what's going on here? These robots are producing monkeys. That's bad. Oh, don't want to fall off the edge here. Okay, seems to be melee seems to work best on these guys. I feel like I should switch back to Dick. I know how Dick works, you know. You get used to Dick after a while, and then, you know, nothing but Dick seems to work for you. This entire Let's Play is just going to be Dick jokes. I know it.
These rickety old things, the higher up they went, the more they sounded like they were going to fall apart. I'm amazed that no one ever got hurt, or worse, riding these things. Well, there was the actor we originally cast for Dick's role, but we don't talk about him.
Okay, what is this thing? It's a snake! Okay, can we just stay on this? Will this bring us to the top of the deadly tower of monsters? I don't know. We keep getting hit by the flame.
Ooh, you really start to get a sense of how high up our heroes have been climbing here. Reminds me of how the crew always used to.
Yeah, there's a ghost pirate ship
how
for
high
some reason.
Everyone was. Ooh, those jokers. They'd even say it when we were filming the grounded scenes. And they all giggled like school children whenever they mentioned it too. So I'd make sure to laugh even harder so they'd know I was in on the joke. Whatever it was.
Ooh. Yeah, I think I'm supposed to do the whole aim down thing here. Let's do that. Okay, have we made it? I think we've made it. Okay. Cool. So we have ascended to the top of the deadly tower of monsters. Let's switch to Dick. Because Again, I know how to handle Dick. The Snake Tower. Top of the Snake Tower. How come we can't go in here? Okay, now we can go in here. Oh, it's the monkey! Or the great ape.
I cannot fight this beast here. I must make for higher ground.
Okay, so I guess we gotta run up quickly. Alright. Cool, I can do that. We may have to Shatner roll a little bit. Shatner roll! And I just ran past that thing. Not if I'm supposed to. Okay. Seems to be doing okay so far. Run, Dick! Run! See, Dick, run! Run, Dick, run! See, monkey, climb! Climb, monkey, climb! There's probably a reference you don't see on the Let's Play very often, a reference to Dick Jane books.
They actually built sets back then. Props, walls, you name it. Then, you moved bits and pieces around and created whole new scenes. We were efficient. I adopted that technique to my wardrobe, too. If you mixed and matched efficiently, you could get by for years on only a handful of shirts and underwear.
What about pants? Amy died, Amy. Run, Dick! We don't have time for your shenanigans. Ooh, he's getting close. He's getting real close. Okay. Have we made it to the top? We've made it to the top. This feels like the top to me. He's glowing red. Oh, okay, don't run into the shockwave. Gotcha. Okay, I didn't think I ran into the shockwave that time. Anyway, I was gonna say, what happens if we stay here, but apparently that's not a good idea either. Can I attack him like this? Yeah, I can. That's it, Monkey Man, I am wailing on your nipple. Ooh. Okay. Shatner roll! Okay, I need these health cubes. We need a healthy Dick. Apparently you can Shatner roll into the shockwave. Oh, he's losing his mind. Ow. Seems like these guys hurt more than the giant ape does. That makes no sense. Shatner roll. So anytime you want to die, Mr. Monkey Man, that would be fine with me. Okay. Looks like the end tip for him. On the go here. What's going on?
I can never get enough of these free-falling shots. Something so invigorating and freeing about them. Like sticking your head out of the sunroof while driving on the freeway.
Okay, is there like a grain silo that was supposed to fall in or something? I have no idea. I love the eyes on the monkey, though. He looks super surprised. He's gonna be eaten by the sea monster. We're just going to land on his tummy. He's got a soft tummy, apparently. And I still have no idea why there's a pirate ship. Achievement unlocked. King of the Tower. So, I think we're going to end things off here. First, though, we should hit our checkpoint, our next checkpoint, so we don't...
Oh, the fearless sea monster.
Yeah, the sea monster.
Always patrolling the shore, eagerly awaiting for his next meal.
Okay. So, where is the next checkpoint? There's a gold cog over here. Can we get to that? Ooh, we have one. So where are we supposed to go next? Because the camera's pointing this way. So you'd think we'd have to travel in this direction somehow. Okay, there's an elevator here. Elevator go up. Okay. So where is our checkpoint? Where are you, checkpoint? Why can't I find... So can I go up here? Will this work? Okay, so this is our checkpoint. Anyway, yeah, thanks for watching. Hey, if you like what you saw here today, think about liking the video, subscribing to the channel. We'll see you next time. Take care. Have a great day.